نحمد الله حمدا طيبا جميلا كثيرا، الذي خلق السماوات والأرض، والذي خلق الظلمات والنور، وبعد، ثم الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ببركة إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه صلاة وسلاما عليك يا رسول الله، صلاة وسلاما عليك يا حبيب الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا شفيع المذنبين. وبعد، we glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this auspicious day, which is Yawm al-Jum'ah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Ya Rab, in this day, please grant all our marhumin Jannat al-Firdaus, inshallah, amin. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that any person, anyone who has any type of problem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy, inshallah, for us. Salutations be upon those who are following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and will follow Muhammad right up until in the day of Qiyamah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include all of us here, inshallah. Ameen, inshallah. Naam, brothers in Islam, you know, speaking in a masjid where our akhabirin have spoken, it makes me shiver. So when you see me shivering, please don't mind that shivering. And hear what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got to say in Al-Quran, thumma hadith, inshallah. This is how we grow, inshallah. Especially when you are called by awliya ikram that come and speak in this masjid. And more so, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of y'all. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us, inshallah. Naam, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Since we are after Laylatul Mi'raj, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and make it easy for us that we follow whatever was said in all the nights, inshallah. And I want to speak to you just about the importance of also Laylatul Bara. Inshallah, it's a very big night. I'm also in one trouble, not in trouble, but you know, I'm in a group where I find that people are trying to go against my sayings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are saying, Ya akhi, what you are purporting and what you are supporting in this night, it is bid'ah, and all those who are celebrating are ya'an ahlul kufr. And these are the things which we find nowadays. But then we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all those people, inshallah. Because if somebody needs guidance, we are the ones that have to make dua for him that he guided, inshallah. But within this night, we need to understand one thing, that there are ahadith. Yani Allah says in the Holy Quran, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Yani he says to Rasulullah that Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قم الليل إلا قليلا, that wake up in the night, have some time that in that night you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now you and I understand that when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the night ayajuz, they are accepted. But when we come in such nights where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen especially for us, we need to commemorate this night, inshallah, and make sure that we know that Allah says in the Holy Quran, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, tatanazzalul malaika 'inda dhikri salihin, that the malaika of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they make tanzil, they come down for that group, for that congregation where they are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this night we find that we are not in the clubs, we are not in our couches, but we are commemorating and we are trying to get the pleasure and the closer from to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is sahih. If you are trying to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are sitting in such mahafil, how more do you want? Yani in hadith from Uthman ibn Abi As, he says that qultu ya Rasulullah, that he comes, that he speaks. It's another hadith where yani he says that إذا كان ليلة النصف من شعبان that when the same night comes ينادي منادي that a caller calls. When people are commemorating such night, a caller calls. So now those who are guhala, who are ignorant, they know about this ahadith, but they are hiding. Because why? They are hearing from the imams, from the imam, not hearing from my aqa and your aqa, who is Huzur Akram, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now that caller shall be calling, he shall be calling by saying, هَلْ مِن مُسْتَغْفِرٍ فَأَغْفِرْ لَهُ. Is there anyone who is asking for istighfar so that I can forgive him? Now they are busy saying that no, this is bid'ah, you cannot commemorate. But such munadi al-munadi, such callers are calling that is there anyone who wants to be forgiven so that I forgive him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking. Now we are there in those nights and we make sure that we are asking for istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Then if we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yet Allah is there, is asking, is there anyone who wants this deal? Not other people who want other deals, but the deal that me, I forgive him. Instead, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that it carries on. He says, "Hal min sa'il fa'a'tiyahu." Any who is there, anyone who is asking, so that I can give him anything in that night which you ask, Allah subhanahu wa taala is there to give you. But then there are two things which we need to understand. One is istighfar, and one is to ask. Now when we speak about istighfar, make sure that when such nights come, you go and ask for forgiveness for whomsoever you have wronged. Because even Hadrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala, whenever he used to enter the masjid, you know, some people are maybe sitting outside of the masjid, and whenever he used to come and enter the masjid, by mistake he kicked someone, by mistake. So he went in. So this guy, he says, "Aya Amir al-Mu'minin, don't you have eyes?" Then he says, "Yes, I've got eyes." Then he says, "How can you hit me?" He say, I hit you by mistake, so please forgive me." Now the Sahaba Ikram, they ask, "Ya Amir al-Mu'minin, what is it that you just only answered this question?" Yet the person was very angry. He says, "You know what? He asked me a question, so I answered him. Finish." So these are the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, radiallahu anhum wa radu anhum. These are the people when Allah says, "I am happy with them and they are happy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." So before you come in this night, are you happy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because Allah is asking, "Do you want for me to forgive you?" And if you want for me to forgive you, then come and ask istighfar. Because Allah says, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الظُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Who can forgive except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you go to your brother or to your mother or to anyone and you ask for forgiveness and they don't forgive you, remember that sin goes back to him. Because you have asked for forgiveness and he didn't forgive you, and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, "Ya Rab, forgive me," so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you. So within this forgiveness, we are living in a time where even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes mention. He says that when we are in this time and there are signs of Qiyamah, where when you see the signs of Qiyamah, you find that everyone is in trouble. It's either you are doing that sign or you are seeing somebody doing the sign. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put us into only good signs, inshallah. Because why? You know, this dunya, it is so much so that even the couplet come to mind. It says, "Jageji laga neki dunya nahi hai." It says, "Jageji laga neki dunya nahi hai, ye ibrat ki jahe tamasha nahi hai." Because why? Mile khak mein ahli nishan kaise kaise, mile khak mein ahli nishan kaise kaise, makin ho gaye la maka kaise kaise. So it is for us to understand that wallahi, go in Palestine, how many people that were so rich that they had dollars in their banks, but a bomb just come and they wake up in the morning, they don't even nothing. They are the ones now who are asking for money. Yet just yesterday, they are so rich in such a way that they didn't even be so generous. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them understand that with what I have, أنتم الفقراء يولا فقراء يولا فقير come to me and when you come to me when you need استغفار come to Allah سبحانه وتعالى then he is forgive you, he will forgive you. We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive us all inshallah. And more so we understand that within this night it is a night that you need to humble yourself. من تواضع لله رفعه الله رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says صحيح. He says anyone who humbles himself in front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى Allah elevates him. Now one thing is at that night you'll be humbling yourself. And second thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not only elevate you, but He'll make sure that He forgives you also. So these are the things where we get to understand that even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that I make istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 70 times a day. So if Habibullah can ask istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how about you and I? Look at the rahmah to lil alameen. Look at the mercy unto mankind. Look how he showed us that ya ikhwan fil Islam, if you need something, if you need anything, come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he also, if you go via him, it's also more rewardable. Because why? We need to make sure that when we come via al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then who can forgive except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we get that maqam, we get that point, and that opportunity to hold in the daman of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And ya ikhwan fil Islam, this is a sacred night. And even Sahaba Ikram, he says that we've never seen Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fasting more in another month than this month of Sha'ban. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, yes, people forget in that month of Sha'ban. They forget about Rajab and they forget about Ramadan. They are in the middle of the month. They forget of those 2 months. And if they forget of those 2 months, then I need to make sure that in that night of that same night of Nisf Sha'ban, that same night I need to make sure that I ask istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after that also I wanna fast, so that if I fast, because at that night the amal in the same month that the amal are taken to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that I want to make sure that when my amal are taken to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa ana sa'im, I am also fasting on that night. So we need to understand one thing, that when we get such things, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. Because why? Speaking in a masjid where it is in the company of awliya ikram, it gives me a great pleasure and humanity in my heart. It makes me more humble. Because why? If they can teach us the meaning of وَرَفَعَنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ, that with rafa, with you humbling yourself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can elevate you. Not by only elevating you, the people after you shall be talking about you. So we need to make sure that we speak about awliya ikram in such a way that even in the time of Hajjaj bin Yusuf al-Saqafi, you know, he was one of the tyrant person. He was so tyrant in such a way that when he was angry, he used to just go out and kill anyone. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. So now that's how he wanted to be known. So somebody comes in front of him, he reads surah, يعني, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَخْرُجُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجَ. He says, Allah. Somebody says, you are reading mistake. You are making mistake in the Quran. وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجَ. It's supposed to be. Then this guy, he tells حجاج يوسف الثقفي, he says, yes, in the time of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, you know now, when kings are ruling, those who are following, they're gonna go with the king, or some of them will dispute. But in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was only وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. But in our time, in your time, you king, that is only وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَخْرُجُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. People are leaving Islam because why? As you as tyrant. So when we look, يعني أولياء كرام, They make us so that we come into Islam and we love into Islam and we hold into the Dhamma and we are elevated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why it is stated that خلق say أولياء أولياء say رسول أو رسول say Allah Hamara Nabi. So it is for us to understand that within this nights, we need to make sure that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. Otherwise, we are not going to find the tranquility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we need to understand one thing. Before we enter into the month of Ramadan, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes mention. You understand that in the night of Mi'raj, he was given one of the gifts, which is As-Salah. And here we are, coming to Sha'ban now, the night of Sha'ban, before the Ramadan, there's one hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam warns us. He says, amongst the signs of Qiyamah, now look at the ilmul ghayb of Ayan Nabil A'adham sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, amongst the signs of Qiyamah, tumatu fihi as-salawat. Some of the salahs shall be performed incorrectly. What is the example? You find that nowadays, even the Hufaz, they need to make sure any Hafiz who is sitting here today, prepare yourself for Al-Quran. Don't prepare for yourself for the big night of Laylatul Qadr so that you can get your Nazrana. Inshallah, it is for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the only thing, Rasulullah, why did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, tumatu fihi as-salawat, some of the salawas shall be performed incorrectly. You find that in the month of Ramadan, when the month of Ramadan comes, you find that some of the Hufaz, when they read Al-Quran Al-Karim, you don't even understand what are they reading. And it makes sure that even some of the our Taraweeh won't be accepted. Because why? The same person who is in front of us, he is not reading the Kalam of Allah. He is reading another Kalam. So that is why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, tumatu fihi as-salawat. Because why? Some people are in salah, yet they are outside. Yet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, izhad fi dunya yuhibbuka Allah. Dismiss yourself. Cut out with the dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. And when you are in salah, when you are in salah, another person was imam, ya salam. He was imam. And when he was imam, he says, Allahu Akbar, it was salatu dhuhr. He carries on with the salah. So the muqtadis are following. Then when they are following, and he's supposed to be leading four rakats, right? Then he comes to the third rakat. He says, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Now the people ask now, ya Imam, you read three rakats. You're supposed to read in four. He says, no, I read four. I know. He says, no, you are wrong. Now they were arguing. Now these muqtadis, they ask him, okay, now tell us, what is it that you are so sure that you read the four rakats? Because we are sure that you read three. He says, yes, because in my salah, I counted all my four businesses in salah. Now you find that people, they've got such concept in salah. That is why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, in the signs of Qiyam, some of the salahs will be performed incorrectly. You find that a brother, he is in salah, he is just waiting for imam to say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, so that I can go back to my mobile phone. Ya salam. And you find that even if within that, when the imam says assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, he runs instead of hearing the imam saying rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhaban nar, a great dua. You want to run and go to your mobile phone and check who has pinged me, which business. Yet the imam is asking for all of us that Rabbana Atina, you are not concentrating on what the imam is saying. You are concentrating on your business. How are we going to find the tranquility from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And Ibrahim bin Adham, he says, Idda'aytu muhubba Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You'll claim to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa taraktum sunnahu, but your left is sunnah. وكيف يستجاب دعاءكم how will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer our du'as, ikhwan? Before I close, he says, ادعيت مع دعوة الشيطان, you'll claim to be the enemies of shaitan, وأطاعتموه ووافقتموه, yet you'll follow shaitan and you'll made friendship with shaitan. وكيف يستجاب دعاءكم how will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer your du'as? That is why you find that people are crying for the rise of Islam. People are crying for the rise of Islam, that yet some people are rising after the sun has risen. What is all that? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. Time is gone and we need to make sure that we act upon what is all it said. Let it doesn't enter this side and come on this side. Ya ikhwan, we are self-motivated. We are Muslims. We are self-motivated by Quran, ثم الحديث, and Sahaba Kiram, then Awliya. So we've got all the soldiers within us. We've got all the equipment within us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. Please, if I've said anything wrong, please forgive me. You are most welcome to correct me, inshallah. Because why? وَغَيْرُ تَقِيٍّ يَأْمُرُ النَّاسِ بِالتُّقَى طَبِيبُ يُدَاوِي وَالطَّبِيبُ رَمَضَانِ. It is in a sense that a person advocate piety. You know, me telling you all to become pious, it's like tabibu yudawi wa tabibu maridun. It's like a doctor who is treating a patient, yet he himself is sick. So if I am sick, I want you all to, what you call, to make it easy for me, inshallah, by reminding one another, inshallah. Wa sallallahu ala nabil ummi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our Jumma, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.